going to the field next door to Jim and Peaches. So
good morning, it's sunshine in Wales.
I'm so excited.
Good morning. So, whoops. Excusing the fact that I am looking like this. It's a very exciting day. It is new pony day. So, I was going to vlog this, but I've decided that one, it's embarrassing vlogging in front of people you don't know whilst you're just like loading their loved pony into the trailer. And two, I'm going to be way too excited to even remember to vlog. So I'm giving you guys an introduction. I'm telling you that I've literally just spent 12 hours worth of a night shift going, it's new pony day, 4 hours to go, 3 hours to go. We are going to pick up Pepper. Now, Pepper was a little bit of a lockdown buy. Seen a pretty pony on Facebook and decided I want the pretty pony. Did I need a pretty pony? No, I didn't. Could I have lived without the pretty pony? I sure could have. I don't know how I'm going to live with the pretty pony, to be honest. But we're going to get her. She's coming home with us today. And I'm kind of half dreading it, half looking forward to it. So as far as I know, she's never loaded into a trailer before. So this is going to be fun. Hence why I'm not vlogging it. It's going to be a stressful enough day as it is. I don't want to be that weirdo who just stands there with a camera all day. Plus, I think my dad would genuinely lose his temper with me. So we're going to be heading off in, I don't even know what time it is, a bit. It's 8:30 now, we'll be heading off in a bit. We need to be there for about 11. We need to try and get her onto a trailer, and then I'm so looking forward to introducing her to Jim. This will be the first time in the 10 years that I've owned Jim that he will have a field companion the same size as him, if not slightly bigger. I don't quite know how big she is yet. So this is gonna be really exciting. I've literally packed everything about a week ago into the truck, ready to go and get her. We had a little bit of a malfunction with the trailer. Our trailer broke a couple of days ago, so I genuinely cried thinking I couldn't get my pony. I've had to wait 2 weeks to get her passport through, but it is finally, finally here. And coming home. So I am gonna go home, I'm gonna get changed, I'm gonna get everything into the trailer, get in a hay net and stick some treats in my pocket as bribery, and we're gonna go get my pony. So I'm going to make a little bit of a video of like clips that I've collected of her. So this probably won't go out today, which is, I think it's the 24th, it's a Saturday morning, it's a very beautiful Saturday morning, it's sunshine in Wales. Anyway, so probably won't go up today. It will be up by the end of next week though. So I'll gather some clips of her and I'll just put them in, find a cute little song that fits her, and introduce you guys to Pepper. So yeah, I'm so excited. I've never bought a pony. It's always been my dad buying me a pony, or oh, there's a little Shetland pony in the field that's free to a good home, can we bring him home? Well, there's no choice because I've already brought him home. So this is really exciting. What I'll do is stop filming now, and then like later on after she's like come home and I've got time, I will give a little vlog as to what we're planning to do, why we bought her, and more about her in general. But all you guys need to know is it's pony day and I am as pumped as pump gets. I haven't said that word for years, but this is so exciting. So I will check in with you guys later and I hope you love her as much as I do, because I can tell you now, the next couple of weeks, there's gonna be a heck of a lot of pictures and videos of Pepper on my social media. So I apologize in advance, but I really don't care if people don't like it because I am obsessed with her. So see you guys in a little bit, hopefully with Pepper in tow,
I'm a very grumpy dad when he realises that I'm going to be skint for a few months and the horse doesn't load. So wish me luck. See you guys later. She hears peaches. Pepper meet peaches, eh?
Meet Pepper. So she's been here for a couple of hours. She's going to the field next door to Jim and Peaches. So wish us luck. Go.
He said, let's get out of this town, drive out of the city, away from the crowds. I thought heaven can't help me now, nothing lasts forever. But this is gonna take me down. He's so tall and handsome as hell. He's so bad, but he does it so well. I can see the end as it begins. My one condition is, say you'll remember me, standing in a nice dress, staring at the sunset, babe, red lips and rosy cheeks. Say you'll see me again, even if it's just in your wildest dreams. Wildest dreams. I said no one has to know what we do. His hands are in my hair, his clothes are in my room, and his voice is a familiar sound. Nothing lasts forever.
Hello everyone. So I realised I never filmed like an ending to my vlog / bringing my new pony home. Pepper's been home now. She came home on the Saturday. It's now the Wednesday and I'm going back to work after a few days off. So she's been home for what, 4 days? And she's settled in quite well. Oh, break on. Initial plan was to put her in the field next door to Jim and Peaches so they could get used to each other, but they were so chill around each other. They went straight in the field together on Saturday afternoon, and yeah, they were really good together, to be fair. Peaches has taken a little bit more time to get used to Pepper than Jim has, but they're getting along really well. I left them to it on Sunday. I popped over to give them a feed. And Pepper was the first to come to the gate. She stood by the gate for about 5 minutes waiting for me to arrive because I was walking, and it took me a while. Peaches and her wouldn't even look at each other when eating. I don't know if that's just a mare thing, but if they looked at each other, there were squeals, and I thought, oh God, roll on putting electric fencing up because these two are going to like murder each other. Anyway, in the middle of all of this, Jim was lame. Jim, I think, has got an abscess or something going on with his foot. He's a lot better by now, but it didn't help that whenever Pepper trotted, Jim wanted to trot. Whenever Pepper cantered, Jim wanted to canter. It didn't matter how much you tried to stop him, he would canter. On Monday, I brought Pepper in. I will put some clips of what we did with her on Monday. So she was tied up to groom. Something I don't know if she's done a lot of. She's been handled quite a bit by her previous owner, by the looks of it, because she groomed from head to toe. The only place she didn't like was under her belly and her legs, but we can learn to like that. Whoops. Then I brought out a saddle pad and a rug. Now, when she came home on Saturday, I tried to put a sweat rug on her because she'd sweated. She was sweaty. And she just would not let me go anywhere near her. So I thought, do some work with that. She must have remembered because she let me put it straight on her, tie it up, put the thing under her belly, the straps under her belly, and she was perfectly happy with it. So that is a good sign that she learns from the positive reinforcement of putting it on, and as soon as she stops moving, taking it back off again. So we took it a step further. We put a saddle pad on her for the first time. She literally didn't flinch. She was a bit nervous about having me like pat on it, but what horse wouldn't be? We then worked a little bit on groundwork. So groundwork being, she's quite bulshy. So if she wants to go somewhere, she will push you out the way to go there. So I thought if I teach her to back up, she will stop doing that. So all I was doing was flapping my arms. Teaches her two things. Teaches her not to be head shy because I'm not going to hurt her. And she also learns that when you're in my space, you back up. As soon as you back off a step, I back off a step. And she really did get the hang of it, bless her. So that was on Monday. Tuesday, they were having a day to themselves because the weather was just weird. One minute it was trying to rain and then the next minute it was brilliant sunshine. So I thought, leave them to it today. Gave him a feed, and again, Pepper was just lovely. She was letting me go up to her straight away, not holding the feed bucket, just walking straight up to her as if she was any other horse. Because the only downside to this pony is you have to have food to catch her, which really pisses me off. She's had the head collar on in the field, which I really, really don't like. Anyway, today, Wednesday, I went over there and decided I'm taking this head collar off. So I took the head collar off, I gave them their feed, and then I went back to her to see if I could catch her again. And lo and behold, she let me catch her. So, yeah, I'm really excited about this pony. I'm really, really excited about her. The goal is to get her riding, whether that'll be me breaking her in or sending her off to be broken in, I don't quite know yet. I've lost a lot of my confidence with breaking horses in, but she's proven so easy that I might actually give it a go. We'll see. But there is a lot more groundwork to be done. I'm hoping by the end of next week to have her saddle fitted, hopefully her feet done, and maybe even starting long reining. I don't know yet. We'll see how it goes with that. But until then, yeah, we're just taking every day that comes and seeing how chill she is, because she's so chill. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you enjoy future videos of Pepper, because she's going to be here for a while. I genuinely think I found my next horse, even though I was planning on looking for a three-year-old, 15-hand-ish sports horse type, and I've ended up with a 14-2 British spotted pony. So she's not exactly the youngest either. She is 10. But yeah, she's sweet, so we'll see how we go. But yes, I'm on my way to work and I don't want to be late. So I thought I'd film an ending. I filmed an ending. I hope you guys tune in to the next couple of videos that I've got planned. I'm hoping to be uploading a little bit more now, maybe like twice a month, since summer's coming. And yeah, so see you guys next time.